contact information and my Twitter guys. If I can send you any of this stuff, I'll be more than happy. I'm going to hit the same role, and I probably have more than enough time. So just kind of giving you guys some of the best stuff I feel like we do within the GAP scheme. The number one deal, and I can't take credit for this, this was Rowdy and our other offensive line coach, Mark Broyles. They do a weekly cake boss. So every day when we go in after the game and they grade the film, we have a column that's titled Cakes and Huddle. And so basically what they're charting is every knockdown our offensive line, tight ends, and fullbacks have individually and as a unit. And so we'll have a school record for individual knockdowns. We also have a school record for total knockdowns in a game. And it's something that every Saturday our offensive linemen and fullbacks and tight ends come in, and what they want to know is whoever wins that category, they're the cake boss. And then we have an overall cake boss at the end of the year. And last year, I don't know if you guys saw it or not, but Football Scoop, so every time we get a knockdown, obviously they tag it. And so then at the end of the year, it's real easy for them to go back and pull in all those. And they made a video, just some loud heavy metal music and all that stuff. So anyway, it was just a good way to us to really encourage being a physical football team. All right. So that's Cake Boss. So to kind of get into what we do, we are a two back, we huddle up. We are very non-traditional now. We were what traditional used to be. We look like the old Stanford, Michigan before they made the change, but we're going to get under center in the eye and we're going to bring the ball downhill. So the way we kind of identify our gap schemes is we kind of have two powers. We have what we call two helper power, and we have one helper power. And so kind of how we distinguish that is two helper power is kind of the old traditional two running back power to a tight end surface. And the reason we call it two helper power, Coach Harper likes to do it that way, is to teach his offensive linemen whenever they're working their combo blocks and who they're working back to is they know they have two helpers. They have a fullback and a tight end helping them with the five offensive linemen. If we take one of those out and we run kind of the two-back power to an open side or the traditional one-back power to a tight end surface, now they consider that one helper power because now they adjust who they're working to because they know they've only got one additional guy working with the five offensive linemen. All right, so those are kind of what we major in. We also have a little inside power, and then I'll go over kind of our G tag, which we can tag G to any of these three, and basically it just switches the assignment to who the kick out and who the swab guy is. All right, so just a few of our main coaching points, okay? On our power plays, it's pretty much a mandatory that we are going to have a kick out, okay? So in this instance, a still shot, this is a fullback basically kicking out an outside linebacker. That's a non-negotiable. We are going to get a kick out block. He's going to take an angle. If it's the guard leading on a G call, we're going to aim at that inside shoulder and we're going to try to get that guy kicked out. If we get a real hard wrong arm, we're not going to line the log. He's going to kick that guy out or bury that guy into the line of scrimmage. All right. So that we can get the play started. The second player, what I call a swabber, the insert player, in this instance, it's the guard. We talk all the time about putting your play side shoulder on his inside number, okay, of the second level defender. So you can see right here, this guard is loading up, all right, to put his pads, or we say shoulder, but I mean, we're talking about our basically outside half. But that's so important because we get so many teams that they want to spill the guard to a safety or some additional support player outside. So we really talk in terms of put your play side shoulder on his inside number, all right, and let's get the ball. We want to run the ball. We talk about an A-gap play, all right. So to kind of go back, then the ball carrier is we want him to think it's an A-gap path, all right. We're tracking the inside hip of whoever the insert player, and we're running off his block. So in a perfect world, basically it would look just like this, all right, where we've got the guard fitting the linebacker, the tailback right on his inside hip, hopefully in the A gap, and he's going to insert right inside of that block. Okay, so that's like about as good as we can show it. And I've got some film clips here. All right, so the first look is basically our sharp play. So this is two helper power. We call it sharp. All of our gap schemes are animals. All right, so sharks are our first one. All right, I'm going to kind of get to the clips, but basically I'm not going to – everybody knows how to block two-back power, okay? The big thing for us kind of in our coaching points is that we will take – and, again, I'm not the OL guy, so if you want to get any finer points, you guys are going to have to holler at Rowdy. The biggest thing I'll say is on our coaching points is tailback out of the home position, we will lateral step him to clear the A-gap, and then we want him downhill at the A-gap. All right, so it's just a quick lateral. Quarterback, we're going to reverse out off the midline and try to get the ball deep to the tailback, and then we'll actually fake front side for the power pass, okay? The one thing I'll say, we don't do a lot of vertical double teams. We want to knock these guys basically off the hash. So a lot of times when we talk, we'll talk in terms of if this ball were on the, let's say, the right hash, okay? When we hit this thing, I mean, we want to be about a yard off the hash. I mean, we want it almost going down the hash in a perfect world. Like we were just off the – if we were off the midline, we talk about in terms of the hash. So all these doubles, we're trying to violently knock guys backside. We're trying to build a wall so that now we can get the kick out, we can get the swab on the inside, and we can run this thing down the A-gap. So, again – if you guys want these diagrams, I'll be more than happy to send them to you. I don't want to spend a lot of time on them. We basically block basically our two-back power versus every front. We could run it out of the gun. I kind of like to see power on the same side, which we'll see some instances of that. So we're a big shift team. Here we are running it. Okay, there's the kick out. We got the swabber going inside, inserting. Basically, that's kind of like an ISO block. Guard, we tell those guards a lot of times, hey, you're like the backup fullback. We're going to use you to ISO block. You're just going to wear an ineligible number. All right. So, again, we're building the wall right here with our offensive line. Okay. We've got the kick out. We've got that and the tailback running the path. And I'll get you to a end zone shot here of it. Sorry. Here we go. End zone shot of it. So you can see there's the kick out. We've wall inside number. This linebacker spit it too far outside, so it should be an easy play for us. And then, again, tailback, if you're running that A-gap path, you should never have to cut. Once you lateral step, it's almost like you're running a 40 right down the hatch. All right, and he breaks the tackle and through. So a couple more of these sharks, and I want to get to the next one. I know time-wise, let me get to the end zone because I know some of you O-line guys will – appreciate the end zone. Okay, so we have a shift. Again, we like to window dress the stuff up. Okay, so again, we get a double. Okay, again, we want to basically move guys horizontally, all right, to clear the hash. Sorry, I'm not very good at this huddle remote here. All right, and again, we get the tailback kind of down the pipe right here. All right, so pretty good look at two-back power. Let me give you one more look because I think I've got one with a okay, so this is a – if any of you guys run a wing look, this is a wing set. So, again, you know, they were going to take their outside linebackers and play them outside our wing. So this is just 21 personnel, but now we're in the shotgun and given the appearance, all right, that we're in some sort of spread set. Everybody's still blocking two-back power. Instead of being it behind the quarterback and kicking out, now I'm in a wing and I'm going to kick him out. We're still double-teaming, building a wall. Guard's still pulling, inserting on this linebacker. For me now on power, okay, I like to run it same side. We can do it both ways, but I like to shuffle the tailback over and hit it because now it keeps him on his A-gap track right here, okay? So a decent look at it right here. I think we checked this play. You can see we just slide the tailback right over. Okay, and now he is on the A-gap track. He's on it. So there's the guard pulling. Okay, again, linebacker fits it a little bit wide right here. That's we love that all day long. Fit right inside that. Again, tailback should never have to cut until he gets to the second or third level. Okay, so one more here on two-back power, and I'll get to something different for you. Okay, so you guys that are spread guys and you run your quarterback. All right, here's one where we shift over. Basically, it's kind of like we take the tailback out and put the fullback in, but I'll go back to the original deal here. It's like we're in 11 personnel. This is our true fullback. We've taken the tailback out of the game, so we're nubside trips. Now, what we do is we tell the quarterback is basically he's like tailback. So we call it a skippy step. He kind of pauses in lateral steps, and then he wants to aim at the A gap, just like the tailback. And so this is like a perfect clinic tape for us because of where the ball's set. So we tell these guys, ball carriers, you should never almost have to come off the hash. So I want a skippy step. And then right there it is. It opens up. Guard fits nice off the linebacker. You've got a running quarterback. We did it this year with a Wildcat guy. It can't get any more picture perfect than that. All right. So to jump to a couple other things, we get into see how I'm doing on time here. I'm going to have to hustle. Okay, so we get into some weak side. So this is one helper power. The line knows it's the five linemen and a fullback or a tight end. So this is one helper power. That's your old open side. Two-back power, but then it's also the same call for us if we were to do it out of 11 personnel, okay, because they still know they've got one helper, whether it's a fullback or a tight end, that way when they're working their alignment. So I'm going to give you one of these kind of fast, see if I can, hopefully I can find a one-back look. Let me get to a one-back look here for you guys, and I'll be glad, more than glad to share these guys, this stuff with you guys, get to an end zone shot here. All right, so here's one back, 11 personnel. Again, we're going to double the backside linebacker. We're going to base the end, pull the guard around. Now, in 11 personnel, a lot of times we'll pair this like with pin and pull. So we're getting a lot of seven techniques at a four-man front. Instead of banging our head against the wall and trying to dig that out with the tight end, we'll just block down and pin and pull outside. All right, but again, you can kind of see, tailback, just shuffle over, get the ball, and we just want you right in the A gap. You should never have to cut. Now, this is one I put on here because the A-gap is all crushed up, all right? The A-gap's clouding. What we tell them, like, this is why we need you basically as an A-gap alignment, because when you see the cutback, it's going to be a huge play. So this linebacker right here, 44, is fit out of his gap over the top to try to stop power. We get the backside sealed off. Now, as we're headed to A-gap, it's real easy to cut back into the backside A-gap, and we're off to the race, all right? So a couple change-ups here I want to get to for you guys, just to give you a little bit of everything that we do. Mouse is going crazy here. All right, so this is like our inside power. So now when you're playing these teams that are running a lot of four eyes or even like the threes, the new tight front stuff, instead of banging our head against the wall and blocking down with this tackle, we're going to arc him and kick him with the fullback, all right? Now, our favorite way to do this is to G it, which I'll, if I get to G, I'll show you some of those. But here's an example of this. If we get a front that all of a sudden they slide to a four-down front and there is no B-gap, it just turns into to one helper power. We're just going to regularly kick the five. And so there's, you know, we're not going to panic and do anything crazy with it if we don't get an arc. So here's a look at it. Let me get to the end zone shot of it. All right. So we've got – all right. We end up with a five here. We thought we were going to get a four eye. All right. So we're going to basically down this thing inside and kick him. So it kind of looks like traditional power, but that's kind of our inside power. Instead of, you know, the tackle and tight end doubling this guy backside, hey, we're just going to – inside, go to the backside linebacker, go right here, and we're going to kick that guy. And I got a little bit better look at this when I get to the G stuff. All right, so that's kind of our inside power look. All right, so to go on to the G tag, all this simply does now is we would say shark, wolf, or bison and say G at the end of it, and now the guard and fullback know that they're exchanging. So it becomes your counter. But instead of creating a whole new play, we just say G at the end of it. They just know they're switching their assignment. So let me get to a bison G here, so I can show you guys. We'll use actual counter footwork now with the tailback. So he's going to go 1, 2, 3 away and come back side. Here's a wolf G. So I'll get you a end zone shot of this. Here's a wolf G. So we're faking like we're running to the right. We'll open up like it's inside zone here with the quarterback and come back with counter back away. There's the kick out. There's the swab. Again, our outside shoulder on his inside number. Tailback's a little bit wide here, but we want it to fit inside. And then let me get to one more here and I'll shut it down. All right, so perfect. Here's what I wanted. Okay, so here we are, this state championship game from 2 years ago. You guys that have running quarterbacks, we're lined up in 11 personnel, basically tight end off. We're going to window dress it right here. We're going to fast motion our tailback out. If nobody goes with him, our quarterback can throw this. If somebody goes with him, he's going to peek it. And then let me show you the end zone of it. So this is the inside power I was talking about, okay? So, again, we get a four eye right here. Instead of banging our head against the wall and our tackle blocking down on that guy, we're just going to take our tackle out right here. Now we've called G, so our guard's going to pull and kick that guy. We're going to double here to the backside, take the tight end who's in off on this linebacker, and we've got numbers for days right here. All right, so let me play this out, and then I'll be done. If you guys, I'll stay on the chat, and I'll stay around for a while. Sorry for these drawings. I don't have much going on. There you can see the kick. There you can see the swab, inside power. Again, quarterback, A-gap, go down the hash. Don't be too wide. Pretty good little football play. Kid carried the ball 24 times, basically won the state championship on this play. So I think that's all I got. I'll stay on the chat, take any questions. You guys, don't be scared to hit me up. Drew, I appreciate you having me on.
Yeah, so you had there are two questions. So one,
okay, go ahead.
He asked about what Union did against you guys that kind of made you bump out of your base stuff this year.
Well, you know, in the two-back stuff, they do a good job of really screwing a safety down. And so they basically outnumber you in the box. And so it kind of forces your hand to bump some guys in some different spots and stuff like that. Plus, they got really good players. And so sometimes, you know, instead of marching up and sometimes, you know, it's not going to be a fair fight. You got to take your chances on the outside. So we kind of did some things, game playing them up a little bit.
Gotcha. And then I'll reluctantly ask this question for Lucchese. What's your preferred scheme against the odd stack? Variation of power or more pinball?
We'd probably be a little bit more own team just to kind of combo up on backs. Everything else, you know, when you start doubling the backside, and especially like coach before me, they slant and stuff like that. It really kind of messes with your combination, stuff like that. So we would probably end up being a little bit more of an inside zone team versus that stuff, split zone, and also probably some insert zone.
Okay. And then the last one was from Gum. He asked, would you have your tackle try to cut your four eye on the backside?
Yes. Yes, especially when we're under center. You know, we will – that's kind of about the one time anymore we've gotten to where we really won't cut a lot. We've gotten called for high-low too many times, but that'll be the one side that we allow those guys kind of to go down on the D lineman on the backside and cut those guys off.
Sweet. All right, that's all we got on there right now. So we appreciate it.
Awesome. Thanks, sir. I'll stay around for any more questions.